And so with no further ado, I'd like Mr. Fisher to take the stage, as he's already done. And here's Weaver Quality Models. Give him a hand if you would, please.
Thank you. Thank you. Is this an honor at all? Can you hear me? First of all, our history doesn't quite go back to 1833, but I do. But the company does go back to 1965, when it was manufacturing scale model two-rail old-gauge engines before the tremendous rebirth of the hobby with the three-railers that I suspect most of you comprise the group of them. I would like to talk about a few new things. First of all, our new catalog. If any of you did not pick up one of the spring catalogs, there are some more up here. My associate Jim here has some. And on the cover, I'd like to point out a real anomaly to me, and that is the reissue of the BP-20 Baldwin passenger locomotives. We produced those, I believe they came out last fall is when they actually hit the market. Well, we sold out on the first run. Some of you are still waiting for yours, and I have to apologize for that, but there are more coming, and we decided when we did that to not only have the five stripe in both green and red, but we also did the single stripe, which was a repaint of that from the original engines. So you have a choice now, or if you'd like, step up and buy one of each. But I never realized that a locomotive that had seen service on only one railroad for only about a 10-year period could be that popular, and it sure has. The biggest news that I have for you is that our Pocono is finally just about here. Now this is a pilot model of that locomotive. It's operable, but do any of you know what's wrong with it? The original color was of the lettering was a yellow, gold color, as they called it. So hang with us. We're still a couple of weeks away. It'll be probably the beginning of June, and the correct engine, this one is correct in all of its details and its mechanical components. And I think it's a gorgeous engine. This is going to be just one of the top-notch engines that we've produced in years. It was a comparatively small railroad when you compare it to the Pensy or the New York Central or the Union Pacific or Santa Fe. The Lackawanna was nonetheless a popular railroad, both among rail fans and song and in movies and all. So that is, I would say, 6 weeks and we'll have them in stock. In the catalog, on page 3, you'll notice a new concept in there. We call it hitting for repairs. A car upside down on a flat car that had been obviously in a wreck, and it's being returned to the shop for complete overhaul and repairs. The trucks have been removed, and it's upside down on the flat car. There's a picture of a prototype car going in just that way. We just thought it'd be kind of fun to do something a little bit different to have instead of just a standard freight car, we'll have a car that's really doing some needed work. I think you'll enjoy that one. Also on, I believe it's on the same page, are the 35-foot trailers. Now we've decided to offer those separately, not just with the 50-foot flat car, which have been very, very successful. We sold out in the first run. We're almost sold out in the second run. We've introduced some new road numbers and some new truck company names on there. And so that is still a very much a fresh and desirable train, the 35-foot trailer on flat cars. The next engine, could you hand me the brass? Yes. Thank you. This is a pilot model of the next engine that we're going to have. This is a Canadian Pacific G5A Pacific. Now, these engines were very popular on the CP, ran name trains and lesser trains all over the country, and there are some of them still in existence. One of them, or actually three of them, are in Ohio on the Ohio Central, and they're going into that new Age of Steam roundhouse that you may have heard about. But number 1293 is operable. It may operate on the Cuyahoga Valley line this September up in the Cleveland area. So if you're interested in prototype live steam, that engine may be there. I know that the 765 nickel plate Berkshire will also be there, so it could be quite an exciting time on the Cuyahoga Valley line. But this engine, I want to say we're intending to produce it as a Canadian Pacific engine, but for special orders, if you are interested in an Ohio Central engine, and I have a picture of the way that engine looks today in these colors, you'll have to place the order before it comes out. We're not intending to put these into inventory, but we will build them specially for you if you do want an Ohio Central version. The number is 1293, and if you can place a pre-production order on that, we'd appreciate that and have a little bit of... I would really like to surprise Joel and sell more of the Ohio Centrals than I do of the Canadian engines, but I don't think that's going to happen. But both of them are prototype and very good engines and very well respected engines. The engines operated right up until the end of steam in Canada. The one following it will be in the catalog there. It's the Lehigh Valley Black Diamond. It's very similar to the one that was made about 15 years ago called the John Wilkes. I have to be careful not to say John Wilkes Booth. He was a different one. They didn't name engines after him. But the John Wilkes was a popular locomotive. It was a streamlined Pacific. The Black Diamond is similar, but not exactly the same thing. There's a lot of fundamental details that are different between the two of them. Both of them were streamlined. Both of them were styled by Otto Kuhler. And both of them ran regular service on the Lehigh Valley. So that will be the next... major engine that we do probably anticipate the fall delivery, the fall of 2012 on that engine. Have any of you been to the Pennsylvania State Railroad Museum here? In your last day, we've decided we're going to do a car that's in there, and it's been very popular. It's called an H30 covered hopper car. Now, there's an H34, I went over there earlier today. There's an H34, which is a different kind of a car, and an H30. It's a very distinctive looking car. The Pensy had it. We will be doing that, and it will be out, perhaps in fall, maybe next winter. In the same series that our very successful wagon top B&O boxcar has been. We've almost sold out on those. Totally right now. The H30 was made was painted in Pennsylvania colors, Penn Central colors, Conrail, and Norfolk and Western. And we will have different varieties of paint jobs in each of those railroads. So it'll be a pretty popular car. It'll be a plastic car, and we think we'll sell a lot. We think it'll be a very good car to produce. Our filling station, I don't know if you've seen it. Yeah, next thing that built. It's finally here. If you guys have been waiting for this, it's a great way. Everybody's got a corner on their layout. They don't know quite what to do with it. This is designed to be in a corner, and it's a filling station. What we have, let me have that, please. We have, instead of putting the names on it and identifying it with some company you don't want, instead we have these pressure sensitive decals that you can take and put any company that we have listed here on there, plus the names and a lot of other signage that's on here that you can cut out, put onto the car and have, I mean onto the filling station and have your own gas station that may bring back some memories of when you were a kid. I can barely remember seeing covered filling stations like that, but I guess they're coming back, don't look like that. But this has been a long time coming and we're waiting for it. This is a brass model, by the way, if you didn't know it. I would like to mention Weaver Steel Coat Paint. Our paint line is one of the more important parts of our continuing service to all of you. We offer paint in 6-ounce spray cans, in 1-ounce bottles, in 2-ounce bottles, and in felt paint pens, felt tip paint pens. We have about 80 different colors available, so you can match other colors if you want to just do some touch-up, or if you want to paint a particular piece, any color you want. We certainly have an assortment that will cover it. But the scale, and there are two types of scale coat paints. The regular scale coat is intended to be for a metal covering. It's a relatively, it bites hard and does, but for plastics we have scale coat 2, which is designed to cover plastics well without harming the plastic finish itself. We also have a product called Rinse Away, and it's our number 56. I've read quite a little bit on the internet and some of the forums recently about people are having problems stripping plastic items. Well, Rinse Away is intended to be a plastic stripper. It won't harm the plastic while it'll take the paint off. It comes in 16-ounce bottles, one pint bottles, and it's designed for a paint remover for plastics. Just so you know that that's available if any of you do your own work on it. And then finally, let me have the Delta. In the catalog is this car. How many of you know what Delta Lines is? You know where it ran? It ran in the basement of a railroad in New Orleans. Frank Ellison, the famous author, that had the name of Delta Lines. These are commemorative cars of Frank Ellison's layout, Delta. He was a famous author from the late 30s all the way into the 1950s. In his articles appearing in Model Builder, in Model Railroader at different times, and very knowledgeable. He was kind of the beginning of steel train operation. There were times they said that in his basement there might be 10 guys over there operating trains according to train orders, according to waybills, very prototypically timetable operation. In fact, after a symphony orchestra, the New Orleans Symphony, it was not unusual to see a bunch of musicians standing down in his basement running trains wearing tuxes, and that was fairly common with Frank Ellison. This was a commemorative car. It's in a catalog, and we have them available. I also wanted to talk about special run cars. Recently, there was an article about one of the train clubs had taken orders for a special run of a car. And unfortunately, they didn't have enough to make the 500 pieces that the manufacturer required, and they canceled the order and returned the money. Well, I want to let you know that if any of you would like to, or know of someone who would like to, run a special run on a car, we will do it for 100 pieces at Weaver. We can design the car. It can be a prototypical layout of artwork. It can be your own railroad. It can be the name of your business. It can be any number of different things the way you'd want it. We can do it in the colors that you want. But 100 pieces is all that we require, because we're doing this in the United States. It's done in Northumberland. We have the car bodies there. And I'm referring to generally the standard cars that we have. We have box cars, a number of varieties, reefers. We have the modern tank cars, the larger frameless tank cars. We have hopper cars, both coal hoppers and covered hoppers. A broad stock cars. I brought a few of these types of cars that we've done for a group. This is a brand new one for the TCA members group. This one is weathered. We can do that for you too. Please all. This is a DT&I covered hopper that was done, I want to say 5 years ago. We didn't offer the weathering on it as yet, but generally speaking, this club has done three cars of different numbers. We have that ability to change the road number on a car in a particular run. That's no problem at all. It's not part of the 100. You don't have to have 100 of each number is what I'm saying. But just the basic car style. We can do it with our artwork from your photographs, from your drawings, from your own line art. We can make the drawings. And that's a big part of Weaver's. Here's a flat car that we had done with the containers on it, packing cases, which are they're on the car. The cases come loose from the carrier, but these are laser cut wood, and we can do those. Here's a caboose done for Rolling Rock Beer. What I've shown you here are all prototype paint schemes, with the exception of the Rolling Rock. So we can do cars any way that you would want us to do. Just call us for a quotation, send us the information. We do require a down payment. It's not difficult to handle at all. So that's about it from Weaver. We do ask you to stop over at our booth. I think the row is either CC or DD. I don't remember which of the rows it is. Just past the middle aisle, close to Old Gauge Railroading's booth, and right behind Third Rail. So I'd invite you all over to visit, see what's new, see the products we have. If anybody has any questions, I'm here to answer them, if I can. Well, thanks very, very much. Thank you. I appreciate your patience, and I understand that the real reason that you are waiting through my whole presentation was for the refreshments, which are coming.